Okay, I agree that it's Palmer amaranth, but I would call this a Palmer amaranth hybrid. This was collected yesterday afternoon. Probably can see Jefferson City Capitol from where I collected this in the bottom down there, and it's in a field of waterhemp and some Palmer. And what I'm seeing more and more of is this hybridization, or what I would call hybridization, and these waterhemp looking leaves, and sometimes it can be on a more of a waterhemp plant that looks like, and it's got a Palmer seed head and things. We know from the literature that it does occur on a very small percentage of plants that Palmer and waterhemp can hybridize. But let's just call this a Palmer and gain a little respect for the fact that it's taller than I am. And it is, you know, got a base that's almost as thick as my arm. And I just pulled it out of a random cornfield yesterday driving south on 94, right after you get off of 94. Because I know that it's down in those bottoms and I can just pull over to most any field and most people have no idea that they have it. So what you want to look for, and this is towards the back of your book, but what you want to look for is no hair on the stem, the poinsettia type growth habit, and let me just switch gears here a little bit. This is a better way to show this, because here is what I would characterize as a true water hemp. Looks like a water hemp in every way, shape, or form. There's not long petioles. There's oval, oblong leaves, okay? No hairs on the stem. And this is our state flower. This is water hemp. This is a true looking, to me anyway, a true looking Palmer. It's got the more diamond-shaped leaves, broader leaves, long petioles, no hairs on the stem as well, okay? And both of these are in the same field together, and then you have things like that. And so hybridization can occur, but the bigger issue is to make sure you know what this is, because this is not something to play around with, all right? I don't believe that we can really, at this point in time, I think that we cannot shut the barn door anymore. It's out, and I don't know if we can contain this beast. It's out there. I have seen this plant growing in flower pots in the mall.
Yep.
I have seen this plant in landscapes of people's houses. Anywhere that there's cottonseed meal being transported from the south onto dairies in the Midwest, this is now showing up. Wisconsin, Indiana, Illinois, Missouri, Iowa. So this is the number one weed to watch in the Midwest, but to be honest, my opinion, it's probably already out of the bag. I don't know if we can put it back in or not. So it's very important to make sure you know what this is in comparison to this, because it's a much whole different beast, okay? It's a much faster, more aggressive thing. So that was part of the talk, the idea for this stop, is just to reacquaint you with that. I am not going to this year, and here's a Palmer plant that I pulled from the same field, okay? Has anybody seen water hemp flowering yet in Missouri?
No.
A couple of you say yes. But, you know, I just found it interesting that this field had water hemp and Palmer. There's not a water hemp flowering anywhere, but Palmer already had this, okay? So I think there's some things to think about there.